Florence, Alabama has a little something for everyone. The home to the University of North Alabama and their famous lion mascots, Florence is part of the Quad Cities, known for the soulful music sounds that were recorded at the legendary Muscle Shoals and Fame Studios. And in the past 10 years, the historic downtown has seen an explosion of shops and restaurants. Some of the most talented fashion designers in America, like Billy Reid and Natalie Channon with her handmade, craft-inspired designs, have stayed true to their Alabama roots. But among most fishermen, Florence is known for Pickwick Lake, part of the legendary chain of lakes along the Tennessee River. And when the Walmart FLW Tour made its stop here in early June, the conditions along Pickwick were coming together to produce some of the best ledge fishing you could hope for.
20 pounds and 7 ounces, 21 pounds, 14 ounces,
22 pounds and 11 ounces.
The first morning of a Walmart FLW Tour event can seem overwhelming to the casual observer. 170 boats are quickly put into the water, and professionals meet up with their co-anglers before blasting off out into the lake for 8 hours of competition. The work and effort that go into putting on an FLW tournament requires many hands. But the one person who's responsible for the entire event is the tournament director.
Anglers, good morning. A couple of announcements before we get going. Remind you, you've got to go through boat check again today for your catch to count.
A tournament director, most part, they think, well, he's the rule enforcer. But in our company, a tournament director is the person responsible for that event.
Right on up. I think they're ready for you right now. I'll weigh the scale. Can we speed the way up just a little bit? Probably the best thing to do is go ahead and come in from this direction. Hey, now, we've still got some pennants down here, too, on this trailer.
Oh, that's my wife. She won't care. Tournaments come first. But anyhow.
The tournament director has to wear a lot of hats. He has to deal with a lot of different issues. And Bill Taylor, in my opinion, is the best tournament director I've ever seen. And I'll tell you why. Number one, you can call him any time of the day or night.
Yes, sir, Casey.
He'll answer your questions. He'll solve problems for you.
Bring your boat on in and everything and come on in, okay?
There's a lot of work that goes into being a tournament director. I mean, you have to book all these events. You have to travel. You have to find out the ins and outs of the fisheries. So when we get here, we have all the information on a piece of paper where we can read it. He does a lot of work back here. He's not just enjoying a six-pack and a shade tree out here.
The bottom line to it all is, guys, get good water out of that holding tank into the bags. Get them up here as quickly as possible. This is good water here.
Wow. That might be the largest fish we've seen wade in today.
Conservation is huge. You know, you come to this lake 20 years ago, and the fishing is better now than it was then, and it's due to catch release and our conservation effort.
Guys, make sure you get plenty of air on those re-dip water. Make sure you take good care of them. How's the fish care going? Getting them out on one?
Yeah, we finally worked out a plan.
Fish care is so important right here. I mean, I've just got to keep everything going. And so that's my objective right now. I'm going to go check on the fish on the release boat they were wanting.
Bill Taylor loves fishing. And he really takes care of the anglers. He likes the anglers, and he thinks a lot of this organization. And that's what really drives him to make it be the best that it can be. And in my opinion, it's the best there is.
You're acting like you're a little bit tired.
Hard on the
old man. Son, I tell you, it's hard on these young fellas, too. You know, if you can rush it up a little, do it. You're going out on the water tomorrow now, right? No, not the big seat, not the bench seat. Okay. This is a boat seat, like.
Bill Taylor says something like, hey, boys, this is the FWL tournament director, Bill Taylor. We're going to let you weigh in 15 bass, 5 bass, 15 inches in length. Oh, I beg your pardon, it's 14 inches in length this week. Boy? Boy?
Boys, this is Bill Taylor.
Now, boy, you must went through boat check.
Want everybody in the water in the morning, no later than 6:40.
Bill's delivery, he goes kind of slow, then he speeds it up real fast. He says, you know, boys, let me tell you something here. We're going to go on down the lake, and we're going to go over fast, and we're going to be in 3 o'clock. You got me?
We'll line you up all the way around through here, all 20 of us.
It's a tournament angler in the past. I always see things that I can do better, whether it's where the traffic is backing up or where the bottlenecks occur. And that's what I try to do. I love the fact that I like to polish things up.
On the third morning of the tournament, Bill made sure the top 20 was ready to get out onto Pickwick for another day of tackling the ledges. Greg Hackney took over the top spot on the strength of a 31-pound stringer on day 2.
31 pounds, 6 ounces, puts you at 53.10.
Now, as the leader of the pack, he was hoping his school of fish would still be positioned and ready to bite once again. Greg was nervous, hopeful that he could end a 5-year drought since his last time holding a trophy.
I want to make the Forrest Wood Cup, but now, you know, I'm in contention to win, and I want to win. The good thing is I didn't have to catch much to fish tomorrow, so I can wait them out. You know what I'm saying? Like, now, is there another 30-pound bag here? I don't know, but I think there's another 25, you know. It's been a while for me.
Your 2009 Forrest Wood Cup champion, Greg Hackney.
I have not won a major tournament since 2009, and here it is 2014, so it's time for me to win again. I'm not putting any extra pressure on myself, but I want the $100,000. I want it all, the trophy, the win, everything. You know, I want to leave here just next week just laying back. You know, I was 6 pounds in the lead after yesterday, and I'd just soon be 6 pounds in the lead after today. I was either like one guy out or the first guy in, you know, the cup going into this tournament with only two events left. And I definitely, you know, you don't want to go into the last one having to win the tournament, you know, to make the cup.
Here he is, it's a big one too. Come on, baby, stay hooked up.
The thing about it is now, I got 12 pounds. I was 6 pounds ahead of second. I don't know, like 10 pounds ahead of 10th. You know, so I figured just a decent limit of any kind, that's a good problem to have, you know.
Scoop him, man, scoop him. You the man. Thank you, sir.
6 pounder. No, I'm sure I'm fishing tomorrow.
Hackney headed to the weigh-in, knowing that he was one step closer to ending his 5-year winning drought.
22 pounds, 4 inches. He's got the lead again.
Working his shallow ledge for another bag over 20 pounds put the Hack Attack firmly in the lead at the end of day three. The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by Ranger Boats, still building legends one at a time. Experience more at evinrude.com. Plano, protect your passion. Dingo, the big taste dogs love. Folgers, the best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup. And by Straight Talk. Same phones, same networks, half the cost.
Hey, do you really need some?
If you had a package.
Yeah.
I think I left it. I just looked, and I think I left them in the thing. And thank you.
It was a perfect Alabama morning on the final day of the Walmart FLW Tour on Pickwick Lake. For Greg Hackney, everything was falling into place, except when he went looking for a package of baits. But even that worked out for him, as Brent Ayler had a couple of packs to spare.
Will that get you by? You want another pack?
You think I need more than one? If you got an extra. You got plenty?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're right, man.
You're the man.
Good luck today.
Can't beat that, can you?
Might have just cursed myself there.
Pickwick is a relatively thin river impoundment in northern Alabama, and the most productive ledges get pressured on a daily basis. But when the conditions are right, the schools of fish get active and will bite on almost every cast.
We're going to go back to where I caught almost 76 pounds. I can't help it. I've started there every day. I got to go back one more time for a while anyway.
I can't even make a cast anymore without seeing the fish first. It's just, I guess it's one of those things, just save your time and energy and don't throw until they're there, so.
This was the first school I got to fire up yesterday about 11 o'clock. I caught pretty much everything I weighed right here, so figured this would be a good place to start off the day.
See on both sides of those signs, they represent a pipeline crossing. And I guess when they put them in, they used a lot of rock to bury them, or dug up a lot of rock when they were putting them in. So it's just a main river spot with a bunch of rock.
It's just a real straight ledge goes up through here. And I just seen some fish right here in this area. And actually, I really didn't know it was that good. Tournament morning, there was a boat on three of the places right over there I was wanting to start. So I started over there behind the guy, and we fished there for a minute. I said, well, there ain't no one over here. So we come over here and caught 21 pounds and been here ever since, really. About to grow up a little though.
So Dotson connected within the first 5 minutes of putting his trolling motor down. While Michael Neal found his school was fired up as soon as he arrived, and the young pro from Tennessee was hitting it hard and fast.
Nice pickwick fish right there. Tournament ended right now, I might have a shot. Yeah, I couldn't ask for a better start than this. I mean, they're here, they're biting, they're good ones. It's just a matter of getting some real good ones. Need some fives, sixes, and maybe even a seven or two to have a shot coming back to win today. Here's another one. Oh, no. Yes, sir. That's what we need right there. We get us a couple more of them, Hackney's gonna have to really catch them today, boys. It's an easy, easy six. It's pushing seven. That's what we need.
Neal was staying calm, not wanting to squander his opportunity. The river current was moving fast, and almost like a light switch, every ledge was turning on. The same was true for Brent Ayler, who already had three in his live well.
Kind of right on where they bit yesterday. I kind of think like we're on the downriver side right now of the spot. I think the less current we have, I think the farther they're going to go that way.
To me, I think everything comes down to current here. And right now, it seems like they're pulling a lot of current, so I don't really have a timing down on where I need to be when. I think you just have to go to where you think there's a lot of fish and hopefully just time it right.
Oh, that's a big one. Yeah, that's a big one there. That's the one I need. Now we're getting somewhere. Now we are getting somewhere. I'll take that one for sure. Whew. I knew there were big ones to live down there.
Come on, fishy, fishy, fishy.
I'm fishing offshore, fishing a little different than some of the guys, a little more rock involved in what I'm doing. It's not really a school of fish, it's kind of an area. They don't seem to be really grouped off. They kind of be swimming around. Some of them are a little bit deeper than a lot of the guys are going, I think.
I need a really big one this morning.
Not quite to start yesterday. First one was a six yesterday.
Gonna be a keeper.
Oh yeah, that's one of the ones.
That's one of the ones we need, boys and girls.
Those are what you want. We'll put her on the big side. What do you think?
Anything that big deserves special treatment. Just downriver, Spencer Sheffield had both sides of his live well working, and the son of legendary angler Ron Sheffield was on quite a roll.
I'm sorry, I got to throw you back.
So every time I throw up on top like that right there, usually I just catch a 3-pounder. But if I kind of throw more out here on the edge where it breaks off, I catch, you know, 3.5 to 4 pounders.
Oh yeah, mama.
You want to catch a couple?
That's a good one.
I've got 43 schools found. That's what I mean. I literally spent 3 solid days idling, and I probably didn't make 100 casts in 3 days. And I mean, I idled, and I'd find a school about every hour and a half. And the last day I found like 20 schools. But I did find
one spot in particular that was kind of, it was on a, I guess what you would call a community hole, but they were about 300 yards from the main spot, and it's, I mean, just a mother load of them. It's a spot that I go and get me 18, 19 pounds real, real fast, and then I go, you know, looking for better quality.
Good to be culling those. Life's good.
All these fish are looking for is a hard spot, you know, to break the current.
Woo! Big one.
That's a toad right there.
That's the limit, boys and girls.
Less than 2 hours into the final day, and almost all of the top 10 anglers fishing on Pickwick Lake were already looking for bigger fish.
Well, I say small. He's still a keeper fish, but he's not what we're after.
Michael Neal was on the hunt for fish over 4 pounds. So was Greg Hackney. Although he had a limit and the lead, he was anything but comfortable.
Let me tell you, here about 2 weeks ago, I had a 5 pound lead. I lost by 8 ounces.
I knew when we went out there this morning, they were gonna catch them. So I got to catch them. So I don't really think about what they're doing, because I just take for granted when we blast off in the morning, they're gonna catch them.
Most all them big ones that I've caught have all come off that lip. That's the reason I'm concentrating on that lip. The only big ones I've caught up on top have been smallmouth. I knew this morning going out there that I was going back to the place where I had fished the 3 previous days. I don't know what it is, but we're gonna need it. Even though yesterday I didn't catch them as good, I still felt like there were a good many fish left. I kind of think that boating pressure yesterday might have had some effect. It was the first day they had really run some water, and I was gonna be by myself, so I could do, honestly, yesterday I fished a little defensive. In a way, I was kind of guarding my fish yesterday, you know, because the guy I was with was a good fisherman, and he did catch some of them yesterday. Four more of those, done deal.
The pressure of winning at this level is tremendous, and everything has to go right. Robbie Dodson was feeling the pressure to find his fifth keeper, and he was hoping it would finally be a big bite.
Well, actually, if I knew where to catch a hog here, I would probably go hunt them, but no more than I know about this place, I'm just gonna fish these 3 or 4 places where I've been fishing. I've caught 21, 11 here, and my buddy caught 20 here. You know, there's good ones around here if I could just catch 5 of the right ones, but that's a good one, that's a good one.
When you catch a bass down deep off a ledge, it takes time to bring it to the boat, and more time means more chances you could lose the fish. It can feel like your entire tournament hinges on landing this one fish.
Take a lemon and them away.
Robbie Dodson was finally able to breathe again as he finished his limit. Brent Ayler was also out of breath as the ledge he was on was putting out kicker after kicker.
Anything on the Tennessee River, when you get into the month of, you know, late May on, you have to be fishing deep. Not on the ledges, not on the main lake. You can catch them in some of the creeks, you know, creek ledges, but you can't compete shallow right now. The worm and jig are playing a big role for me, because it seems like the fish are kind of not easy to get going. And they're kind of, it's interesting. The way they're set up, you really feel like you can just run spot to spot to spot and just throw that crankbait and catch them. But they're not really doing that right now. Oh boy, Brent, oh boy. Most of the places I'm fishing are probably 15 to 20 feet deep. You don't really have to fish very slow. When that bait hits the bottom, some of them will bite on the sink, some yeah. you're just, you know, dragging it or just kind of hopping it along the bottom, and that's when they bite. But it's not a real slow process and just a dull drag. I mean, that thing hits the bottom and you move it and one bites it. You know, they're pretty aggressive. Oh, that is a fat one. Catching a few tunas.
You're gaining some steam.
I think this crankbait getting on there, I mean, it's just, you can picture it just digging the bottom. It's trying to go deeper because that's the point of long lining, is it lets the crankbait go deep. You can get something like a Strike King 6XD down there to 38, 40 feet if you let enough line out. So you can imagine here I'm in 17, 18, and I'm letting almost enough line out to get that deep. So when you can imagine just down there digging in front of their face, and they either got to eat it or get out of the way. There's one other one. Stay on. Feels like a pretty good one. My arm's hurting from cranking. Don't jump. Don't jump. Don't do it. It ain't that big, but it'll help. May have just figured something out too. It's the first time I've long lined all week. Just threw in these fish, couldn't give them the bites. Maybe this is the trick. So if I can get these river schools out here fired up, you got a good chance to catch a great big one. That one will help. 3-pounder, 3.5 maybe. Bigger than a 2-pounder.
Michael Neal is already one of the best young sticks on the Tennessee River, and every day he learns something new is a bad day for his competition.
It's just so hard to win one of these because of all the variables. Everything's got to go right over 4 days against the best fishermen on the planet. And you know they're going to catch them, so you have to catch them every day.
On the Walmart FLW Tour, if you want to win, there's no margin for error. Greg Hackney had a small limit, and while he hasn't seen a big bite, his competitors were cleaning up.
It was crazy. This stretch is productive still for another. We haven't even gotten up to the top end of it yet. I'm guessing when I slide up a little bit more, I can catch another 4-pounder.
Bryn Ehler had landed over 12 solid keepers to the tune of 20 pounds in his live well. Michael Neal turned to long lining a crankbait for his heavy limit. And Troy Morrow kept landing good bass, but not good enough to cull.
What a predicament.
Robbie Dotson was still running his last catch over and over in his mind, while Spencer Sheffield was continuing to catch fish on nearly every single cast.
These fish are here and have not been discovered yet. And I mean these fish, it's reloading more and more every single day. I mean, it's like this school's so big, it just keeps building. Every time I show up here, it just gets bigger and bigger. Like right here, I'm sitting at 21. The spot comes up on top of it, it's 12, and it's just solid line of riprap up on top of it. And see, these bites here, I'm getting her up on top of the riprap, up there in about 11 to 13 foot of water. Most all your good ones are coming out here, though, in the 16 to 20 foot range. They're holding a little further out off the break. There's one. Oh, that's a big one. Oh, mama. Got it! Yeah, there we go. Little humpback 5-pounder. Love it, love it, love it, love it.
Jason Lambert wasn't feeling any love just yet. He dealt with mechanical issues all throughout the morning, but stayed positive, knowing he would have his shot.
It's a whole timing issue. I mean, at some point during the day, this school and every other school on the lake will fire. I didn't have a limit yesterday till 11:30, and 12 o'clock I pulled in on one school and caught a 6, a 5, and a 3, and it comes in quick bursts most of the time, and it's not out of the question on this lake to catch 25, 26 pounds in 10, 15 minutes.
Lambert was fishing the lower end of Pickwick, slow rolling a swim bait in about 22 feet of water on the main lake.
Big one. That changes the game.
That helps after the morning we've had.
There's one. I hope it's a bass. Oh God, yes, big one. Oh, don't jump. Oh gosh. Give up, give up, give up, give up. Yes, that's a good one there. That's what it's all about. That's a good one. Yes.
Robbie Dotson had his adrenaline going after that catch and was starting to believe he was going to be able to pull some kickers out of this area after all.
I'm just kind of popping this worm up off the bottom, just trying to get him to bite when I really don't want to. You know, I fished here for about an hour and a half and just kind of dragging it slow, so I thought I'd try this, just something a little different to give him a little bit different look. I'm just trying to get him to, boom. I know they're setting here. I mean, I've caught too many fish here this week. That's a good one. Jump, yes, good one. Oh yeah, she got a good omelet. Come here, Lucy. Oh yes, it's a 4-pounder. It's a nice one. I'm glad we stopped here this morning. I almost didn't stop.
Greg Hackney won his last major event back in 2009 when he won the Forrest Wood Cup. He could see the victory here at Pickwick, but with Ayler and Neal putting up huge numbers today, he needed his big fish to turn on.
We are right here where all them big, the giant sack came from, all my fish the first day. This is the end. This is the upstream end of this bar. This is the place where the current hits the bed. I mean, it's the textbook part of it. I never caught one here yesterday. The first 2 days, I catch all my fish here. Yesterday, I never caught one.
There he is. That's a big one. Stay hooked up, baby, stay hooked up. Oh, dang, why did I do that? Where's my hat? Oh, dang. I scared I couldn't get that net out. Dang it, I believe I did that. I can't believe the line broke. That's a 5-pounder. Dang it. That hurts.
Big old fat one. It's a bad decision, but I had no idea because I swung thousands. I swung that other one. I swung every one of them.
Your luck can change instantly in professional bass fishing, both for the good and the bad. And on Lake Pickwick, timing the bite played a role in everyone's luck. For Greg Hackney, timing was off, and missing that 5-pounder was not a good sign.
I'd have culled a 2.5 with a 5. Can't do that. Can't do that.
Timing was much better for the rest of the top 10, especially for Michael Neal.
I mean, you can see them on the graph all day long, and eventually you're going to catch them. When you finally get them to ignite, it's just a pure, straight adrenaline rush. There's no other feeling like it.
Bryn Ayler would agree with Neal, and he was showing no signs of slowing down. He just boxed a 3.5 and a 3.75, and he and Neal were now ahead of Hackney on the leaderboard.
All we're gonna do today is fish ledges and fish kind of the breaks on the side of the ledge, or if it makes a point, we're gonna fish that point where that current comes down and it bulges up on a spot. And that's why those fish are there. It's either a turn in the ledge, an obvious point on the ledge, you know, something that's out of just a straight river ledge. It has to have some sort of jog or turn to it, and that's where those fish really group up. And I think it's because when that current comes down there, it bulges and has an eddy and pushes bait against that one spot instead of just running down the whole thing. It gives them a place where they can get a little bit of break from the current, but have everything come washing by them and feed.
Well, that might be a good one. Can't tell yet. Oh yeah, that's a good one. Oh boy.
Ha ha ha.
Nice.
What every professional wants to do is activate the school, create a feeding frenzy that allows them to throw into it repeatedly and pull out the biggest, most aggressive bass. And Brent Ehler was finding that even after 15 keepers, there were still bigger fish to bring to his boat.
There we go. Oh, that's another big one. That's another big one. Boy, oh boy.
How's that? A 5 and a 4.
I think they're biting down there.
For Michael Neal, the fast start in the morning gave him the confidence that he had the areas he needed. As he rotated back to his number one spot, it didn't disappoint.
That'll definitely go.
It becomes almost hypnotic when the ledge fishing is this good. Anglers leave all thoughts behind and push ahead to their next cast.
I got them fired up. We can keep them going here for a minute. We might get another great big one. My hands are bleeding, sweat dripping down my face, but I can't feel it right now. This is what it's all about. Should have sat here all day. I told myself, I told everybody here, if I had any sense, I'd sit here all day. Oh yeah, good. Come here, fish. Oh, I got too much line out. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Two more of them, we are in the ball game.
I went to this hole yesterday at 12 o'clock. Caught a 6, a 5, and a 3. It's 12 o'clock. We gotta make something happen, so we're headed that way, see what goes on.
Well, things just got pretty slow. Decided to come down here and try this. Had to come back one more time. Right over there, I caught one big one yesterday. And one of the days in the tournament, I caught a 5-pounder. My partner caught a 5-pounder, so I had to come down here at least try it one more time. But right here, this is a big old flat. There's been a lot of fish here. I keep thinking I might catch a good one off this. It's a perfect, it's like 13 foot deep for 2 miles over through there, and it's got about a 12 to 16 foot drop right up here in front of us. It looks perfect, but I haven't caught no good fish here yet, but I keep thinking I will.
Many of the top 10 were rotating through a number of spots, but Greg Hackney was putting all his hopes on his shallow area. Fishing in 5 to 8 feet of water, making long casts and working his bait uphill.
I think what made this place good, again, it goes back to fishing pressure. I think I found a virgin school of fish. I just felt like that in practice, the way they acting. I'm fishing a place that they should have been on the first week of May. There are so many fish there that I can feel the bait running over them before one gets it. I get 5 bites on the first cast. There's so many of them, they fighting over the bait.
Go, 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 go.
Don't let that get away. You suckers! Thank you, Lord, thank you.
The Walmart FLW Tour is brought to you by Walmart. Save money, live better. Mercury Marine, 75 years of marine excellence. Motor Guide, introducing the new XI5 and Pinpoint GPS. Find, navigate, dominate with Lowrance. Kellogg's, from great starts come great things. And by Chevy, brought to you by the all-new 2014 Chevy Silverado.
Oh, this is fun. This is so much fun. That's the best tournament I've ever had. Win, lose, or draw, whatever happens. This has been an absolute blast.
Over 160 professional anglers started on day one of this Walmart FLW Tour event. And as we reached the conclusion of this slugfest, it came down to three men.
That's the kind of day everybody wants to have right here. Have a shot, come back and win this thing.
Michael Neal moved up the leaderboard as his key area was producing big bites and held the lead with 2 hours left to go.
In 2 days, I've caught six over 4 pounds right here. I know there's another big one down there waiting to just nibble on my cricket. I'll give him a little boat ride.
Brent Ayler was having one of his most amazing days on the water in his storied career, but knew he needed one more big one.
I've had several goals that I haven't accomplished, and they drive me. If you ever get satisfied, you might as well quit.
Greg Hackney entered the tournament with one goal in his mind, to come out with a solid finish and make the Forrest Wood Cup, but he moved his goalpost a little further and was now looking for a win.
Without a shadow of a doubt, the best Tennessee River fishermen on the planet were in this tournament. I'm not even in that league. I just found a good spot.
Hackney's always humble, but the Louisiana pro deserved to be right in the mix with the best of the best. His tactic of targeting shallow water allowed him to throw at fish that most of the big sticks weren't even looking for.
Oh, it's a big one. It's a big one. It's a big one. Stay hooked up, baby. Stay hooked up. I know what it is. It's a giant. I don't even know what to say. One more bite like that, and they'd have to catch 30.
Anytime you come to a place and catch, I mean, if you average 20 pounds a day, you can't really ask for anything better than that. I mean, 20 pounds is steep no matter where you're at. That's stout. You do that 4 days in a row, that's 80 pounds. If you ever get 80 pounds on a place, you can't complain. We're coming in. I ain't even gonna do nothing. That's a pretty fish throwback. This is just unbelievable.
While Michael Neal was busy practicing catch and release on 4 pounders, down the lake, Troy Morrow was wondering when he would come across his kicker fish.
I think we're gonna go smallmouth fishing the rest of the day. I'm gonna try maybe make this one drag with that shaky head one more time. And that's the one. That's a giant. That's the one, boys.
That was a huge fish.
Be a big one, please. Oh, there we go. That's a nice one.
Brent Ayler just made the move back to the school he fished first thing in the morning, and the decision paid off nicely.
I've caught more fish today than I probably have all season long put together. Not joking. You take all my tournament days prior to this one, add them all together, and it'll be less than what I've caught today. Oh boy. Oh boy. I can't tell, but that might be a real big one. Stay on, please, fish. Please stay on. Yeah! Oh my goodness! Oh.
Isn't that funny? Since we come back here now, I have three in the box from this trip. That's a little one. That was a little one. Can tell. Yeah, it's a big one. Oh, I missed that sucker. Missed that sucker with the net.
Get in there. Boy, I'm a terrible net man.
That's a new wave of fish that just come up. No, it's not either. It's one I've already caught and had my cool tag in. She's been here. She knows me. All that grinding around, I make three casts and catch three four-pounders.
Oh, my goodness. This fishing is something else.
Hackney added 5 pounds to his total limit in the last hour of the tournament, and while not as big as the limits from Ayler or Neal, he was hoping it was going to be enough.
£20 and 6 ounces, £20 and 10 ounces, £24 and 12 ounces. Wow!
Big bags just never stopped coming across the stage on the final day of the Walmart FLW Tour on Pickwick Lake. But the three anglers who separated themselves were Greg Hackney, Bryn Ayler, and Michael Neal.
Here we go, his 12th top 10 with FLW. This guy knows how to fish deep ledges. From Dayton, Tennessee, I'll make some noise for Lunker Hunt Pro, Michael Neal.
Wow!
Michael Neal brought in 20-pound limits each of the first 3 days of competition, but saved his best effort for day four.
Wow! A 5-bass limit for Michael Neal. 25 pounds and 9 ounces puts you to 93 pounds and 6 ounces.
What turned on today? What worked for you?
I don't know. I caught all my fish off of one spot today. I started on it, caught the biggest fish. I had a limit about 20 pounds pretty quick, within 20 minutes. I left there, came back later in the day, and caught two more good ones in cold. So it was just a special place, I guess.
This guy is the king of the West. You guys make some noise for GoPro Ranger Pro, Bryn Ayler.
Ayler caught 100 keeper fish on the final day, making cull after cull.
Number four and number five need to be big. Number four definitely is.
Ayler had the bigs and put the pressure on Neal over in the hot seat.
You need 25 pounds and 5 ounces to dethrone Michael Neal. It's going to be close because I can tell you already, it's in the 25-pound range. 24 pounds, 10 ounces. Brent, you come up just less than a pound shy.
And then there was one. He is your leader coming into the day. Is it his deal? Striking Mercury Pro, Greg Hackney.
A 31-pound, 6-ounce bag on day two gave Hackney a solid lead to defend from, and while he broke off a 5-pounder today, he managed to land some key fish in the last hour.
Four good ones in there so far. Do you have number five?
I do have number five.
Let's see number five. 5-bass limit. You need 17 pounds and 8 ounces. 21 pounds, 9 ounces. Your champion is Greg Hackney. Wow!
Greg Hackney from Gonzales, Louisiana, wins another FLW Tour-level event. $100,000. I can't say it as good as Chris Jones. Greg, show us your two best bass. I know it's been a while since you won on the FLW Tour. So, man, this is awesome for you.
It really is. I was beginning to wonder if it ever happened again, you know, and even today I started wondering about it at one time, you know, because this morning was a little slow. And about 1 o'clock, you know, it got right, and I caught most of my weight, you know, that I weighed today after 1 o'clock.
This is the day you dream about as an angler, and it's happened for you. Anyone watching online back in Louisiana? Anyone here?
My wife, all my friends at home, my kids, everybody's watching. Woo!
Wow, Greg Hackney almost broke the century mark over 4 days. It's hard to believe that someone could catch 80 pounds and still finish in eighth. Pickwick Lake was truly amazing this week. To get the most comprehensive coverage of the Walmart FLW Tour, including details about the lures and patterns used by the top 10, go to FLWOutdoors.com.